say thank you, Cisco Home, for having us hosting this wonderful event. And thank you, Abby, for, thank you just so much. You've been wonderful. And I thank all of you for attending and our discussion on how to create your dream home without losing your mind and losing your wallet. Now, let me begin introducing you to our wonderful panelists. David Keaton, our, what is he? Contractor. David Keaton is the owner of DC Keaton Home Improvements. He has been remodeling homes throughout the greater Los Angeles area for the past 24 years. Previous careers in business, acting, producing, and garment manufacturing have all contributed to David's success as a contractor. He has top-notch references from both customers and vendors, concise and detailed contracts. He oversees projects personally, has a positive, high-energy personality. He really does. You should have seen him trying to organize this event. I'm sorry, I just had to throw that in. Whew, it's hot in here. And has creative problem resolutions. David is a member of the West Los Angeles and Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, where he serves as board member of the Chambers Foundation. He also is on the Leadership Council for the world-renowned nonprofit Heifer International, known as the contractor you will still like at the end of the job. Are you sure about that? David, one of the most established and reliable remodeling contractors in Los Angeles in 2013, he was awarded Angie's List Super Service Award for kitchen and bath remodeling. And there you have it. So what we have is we have group questions for our panelists. Share with the audience one or two crucial things they should do to ensure a successful remodeling and furnishing project.
Okay, first of all, don't hire an unlicensed contractor. Number two, don't hire a contractor without first shopping around. Number three, don't act as your own contractor. This is like a doctor operating on himself. Okay? Yeah. And when requesting bids, provide all contractors with the same set of accurate plans or drawings. So it's apples to apples, not apples to oranges, when you're comparing pricing. And make sure that everything you and your contractor have agreed to is included in your contract, and don't sign anything unless you understand it completely and thoroughly and agree with it as well.
Well, great. Thank you very much. So we're going to have question number two. What is the value of creating a design build team at the beginning of your project?
As a contractor who's worked with many designers and architects, there's always egos. And sometimes those egos are really huge. And not only the designers, architects, and the feng shui, but the homeowners' egos, and of course, mine as well. You need to get past the egos and work with those that you can trust and respect. And of course, this is a two-way street as well. The designers, the architects, the feng shui, and the contractors must respect the client's wishes. And if not, there will only be bruised egos, chaos, and a disaster in the making. So thus the hiring and vetting of a design and build team, you will discover just who you can and cannot work with. It's best to find this team before taking a hammer to the first wall.
Okay, thank you. Okay, our third question. Briefly describe the services you provide to your clients.
When I started my company 24 years ago, I never wanted jack of all trades. I wanted specialists in each area. So what I'm bringing to your house is an experienced, licensed, and bonded carpenter, an experienced, licensed, and bonded plumber, a licensed, experienced, and bonded electrician, a licensed, experienced, and bonded roofer, a licensed, experienced, and bonded hardwood floor person, and on and on. It took me a number of years to put together the right team, and because I do have the right people for the job, one can rest assured that the project will be done correctly, on time, and within budget. This is the beauty of hiring a licensed general contractor. He has the right people, he oversees the production and the quality control. Plus, you only have to deal with one person, not six or seven tradesmen. Please know that contractors, what we do is we take our bids from our individual subs, put them all together, and we add 20% on top of that. That 20% that you're paying is for me knowing the right people, for overseeing the job, so that you can go and make some money at your job and not worry about what's going on in your house, so that you can pay me and I can pay them and they can feed their families and so on. It's the American economy, right? So, but that's what you're paying a contractor for. That's why I say don't act as your own contractor. The last thing you want to do is come home and find that the tile that was supposed to go in the master is now in the guest bathroom. So, all right, thank you.
That's great. Thank you so much. Okay, our last question before we get into the next individual questions. What advice would you give the audience about choosing someone in your field?
I can't say this any more strongly. Listen to your intuition.
Wow.
Listen to your heart. Listen to your soul. You will know who the right person is. The right contractor, the right architect, the right designer, the right feng shui person. You will know. If you have, and this goes for life, if you have to talk yourself into something, it's wrong. Now, it may be the most expensive contractor. It may be the least expensive, it may be the person in the middle, but you will know who that is. And on another note, if you cannot do the project the way you really would love to have it done due to a lack of funds, wait until you have the money to do it the way you want to. Because every time you walk into this kitchen, every time you walk into the bathroom, every time you walk into that addition, and something is not done the way you really wanted it done, it's going to piss you off. You're going to get upset every time. So if you don't have the money now, wait for 6 months and do it then. So when you do have the money, that's because every time I've seen it happen again and again, I go back to clients, oh, I wish I had bought that faucet. It was only $300 more, but they said, oh, I need to cut my budget, and that's what they start doing. But wait until you have ample funds to do exactly what you want to do.
How does one go about finding a contractor and a good one at that?
Well, ask your friends, ask your coworkers, ask business associates, ask your neighbors who you've seen remodeled. Go and knock on their door. People love to show you their houses, particularly if it turned out well. You know, you'll find out from those folks who they use as a contractor and whether they were satisfied with them or not. Angie's List. Now, if you go to Angie's List, you'll find me on the first page, by the way, okay? All right, but Angie's List is a great source for not only contractors, but for other professions also. $39 a month, I mean a year, and it's well worth it. And after you've met a contractor, check out his references, or hers, and ask if you can possibly see some current projects. I always feel funny about asking people, oh, can I bring some strangers into your house? But if you ask to see, because I'm doing like 5-6 jobs at a time, and sometimes I have keys to the house, I will take people there after I ask the people. But ask the contractor that you're considering where he or she buys their products. In other words, who their vendors are. Go to that store and check out the store. Not only will you get a chance to find out about the contractor, but you'll also see the type of products that are in that store. And you'll get another feel for what level of this contractor is, what level he's at. Is he at the really high end, middle, or is he buying things at Home Depot off the 1095, you know, blue light special shelf? So, you know, and I give my clients, when I go to see clients, potential clients, I give them a shopping list. I give them places to go shopping because I've done this so long that I know every place in town that you can get for the best prices for a good quality product. So they go to these stores and they see the level of contractor that I'm at. But you actually have to go to the store. Don't call somebody on the phone. You actually have to go there. So it serves as a double positive. There we go. You get to see the products, you get to shop, and you find out about a potential contractor.
Okay, thank you. And two more questions for you, and then we're going to collect the Q&A. Collect the panel discussion. Number two, can you briefly tell the audience just what goes into a kitchen remodel and what trades are involved?
I'll try to keep it brief. A kitchen is the biggest thing you're going to remodel in your home. A kitchen costs anywhere from 10 to 15% of the value of your home. So if it's a $600,000 home, it's a $60,000 kitchen at minimum. If it's $1.1 million, you can do a $60,000 kitchen, and it comes down lower as far as the percentage goes and still make it look nice. But that's about what a kitchen goes for. After you've done your due diligence with your feng shui, with your architect, with your interior designer, you will need to deal with the fact that your kitchen is going to be out of commission for 60 days. It takes that long to do a kitchen. If your contractor tells you it's going to take longer than that, you might want to reconsider, because it shouldn't take that longer, and any longer than 60 days to do a quality job on a kitchen, as long as everything is there. If you're still, that's another important thing. If you want to make sure that you have everything there or it's on its way. There's nothing worse than stopping for a week waiting for the tile to show up. It's not only delays the job, but it hurts the contractor because he has other things going on, and it messes up his schedule as well. So first is the demo, and lots of times, and that's always fun. I always give my clients the chance to swing the first hammer, so they can get that frustration out that they've been wanting to fix this kitchen for 24 years. And lots of times, there's internal damage, particularly in kitchens and bathrooms. Water plus wood plus darkness equals? Sometimes mold, but it's termites. Termites love to dance on through, and you'll find them there with their little crystal ball having a party because they've been there since the 60s, all right, and they've just eaten away at your wood. So be prepared for that. Are there walls to be moved? Are there new walls to be built? New windows? Remove the old windows? New doorways? That's where the carpenter comes in. Then you talk to an electrician, and the designer and the architect have already laid out the electrical lights, and you usually wind up moving them 4 or 5 times, I found out, over a period of years, because you just don't like quite the way it turned out. And many times you're going to have to upgrade your electrical panel because according to code. A lot of houses in LA only have 100 amps. You need 200 amps because everything in a kitchen has to be on its own circuit. The refrigerator, the dishwasher, the garbage disposal, the microwave. They didn't know when they were building houses that electricity was going to be so popular. But now everything has to be on its own circuit. So many times you have to spend another $3,500 above and beyond the kitchen to upgrade your electrical panel. And where to put the lights? We talked about that. Then comes a plumber. Do you have galvanized pipes? Well, a lot of homes in LA have galvanized pipes, and so you change them out in the kitchen. Well, let's go ahead and do the whole house. So there's another $2,500 that, you know, to change things out to your plumbing, to copper piping. Then there are repairs to the floors, patching all the holes in the drywall or new drywall. Then comes the installation of the cabinets, fabricating and installation of countertops and undermount sinks, installation of tile for the backsplash, installation of the under cabinet lights and lights and recessed cans, installation of all plumbing fixtures, faucet, garbage disposal, etc., installation of the flooring materials selected, installation of appliances, and you are done. Now, I've done about 75 kitchens, and I had to write this out. You know, I have it in my head, but I didn't want to miss anything. There's a lot that goes into a kitchen remodeling.
Okay, we have to move on to the last question, and then get ready for your questions for the panelists, and be sure your panel evaluation form is filled out. Okay, this is a good question for you, David. What if there's a disagreement with the contractor? How should this be handled?
This is a business transaction, and you want to treat it like any other business transaction, but even more carefully. These people are in your house. So you want your contractor and the people that work for him or her, you want them to be your friend. You want to be friends with them. You know, even if it's on the outside, you know, and you're boiling on the inside, because you just don't want to have this chaos, this negativity going on with your project, because it'll feed through into the kitchen, into the bathroom, into the addition. It's happened to me before. You want to resolve all issues with diplomacy and respect, if at all possible. If you think you can go to the contractor's board and get things straightened out, good luck, that's a year. And in the meantime, you're sitting without a kitchen. So you need to be able to compromise. Please, 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 do not be like the Democrats and Republicans. Compromise. Thank
Great.
You.
Great, thank you. Question is, there's a lot of questions regarding the budget. So how do you establish that? Who would like to answer that?
When I remodel homes, I have a client in this room. I won't mention their name, but they want to spend a certain dollar amount. So we went through their place and looked at it, and the amount of money that he wants to spend is not equal up to what needs to be done. So I'm going back next week, and we're going to try. I'm going to give him other ideas about how to bring his budget down and what are the possibilities that would work to meet his budget. Hopefully we get to that point. So it's a matter of compromise. In the go-go days, back about 6-7 years ago, if you did a kitchen and for every dollar you spent, if you sold it the next day after you finished, you got $1.20. Today, you're lucky if you get that dollar. So you want to be careful about what you spend. Now, if you only live there for a year or so, I do something called a fluff and puff. I know how to fluff and puff kitchens and fluff and puff bathrooms to save you money, but yet give you a nice product that looks really, really good. That's my fluff and puff special. It's a blue light special, table 9.
Well, what I want to say is thank you, everybody, again for coming, and how to create your dream home from those special professionals, and thank you to the panelists and Cisco for hosting this event. And we're going to, and David Keaton, thank you, it was your idea. Mm-hmm. Oh.